Friday night kickoffs, and we're ready for the kickoff. Otsego kicking off, and they'll be going left to right.
12 at the 19.
And Drummond will take the kickoff. And he'll be upended at the 37-yard line, and that's where the Comets will do business.
Well, you know, Steve, we've saw Drummond all game. I mean, every game that we've seen, Drummond has just been the force, being able to do things. And I think you're going to see a lot of him tonight.
Well, again, we've talked about the Comets, and they're going to open up in their spread offense. So they're going to open up in a 3-by-2 set. Bronkhorst from the gun. Bronkhorst, he'll toss, he'll complete. That's quick out, completing to Robert Messenger for a short gain. It'll be a gain of about 3, let's call it 2nd and 7, you'll see. Just a quick out on the outside.
That's just getting loose. That's getting loose right now.
And the Comets are going to the hurry for another 3-by-2 set. This time they'll flip the formation. Bronkhorst, a straight drop. He'll survey and hits Messenger on the crosser up under, and he'll score the first down and get out of bounds. It'll be a gain of about 17.
Hey, Steve, one of the things that Genoa has been able to accomplish all year so far is those little short passes like that, and they've been able to get 10, 12, 15 yards out of them. I mean, people starting to think of Genoa as a passing team then?
You know what? They give you that because they give you a lot of spread. And what they do is they put stress on your cornerbacks. Here we go. Another 3-by-2 set by the Comets. Bronkhorst in the gun. Straight drop. Bronkhorst looking straight. He'll throw again. Oh. He'll complete on the outside to Aiden Antry. Antry had a big game last week, scoring a couple touchdowns. And you see the deep out to Antry.
Wow. What a nice, nice job. This time out
for an injury. We've got
an injury already.
Injury timeout.
We'll just stay here.
Perfect night for football right here on the Toledo Sports Network. Tonight's officials, we've got referee Dean Gregorczyk. Your umpire will be Randy Grant. Your line judge will be Drake Fury. Your head linesman is Tom Dart. And your back judge is Lee Durham.
Been able to do exactly what you said, Steve, when we talked today. You know, they haven't really ran the ball yet once. And I think the Achilles heel for Otsego right now is going to be that pass defense.
Well, what they're doing right now, Mike, is they're putting stress on the secondary now. And what they're doing is they're slowing down a potential pass rush by creating a lot of uncertainty with a lot of the crossing routes, the short crossing routes. And these are safe throws, man. This is a way to get your offense going. But, you know, man, when the rubber meets the road, these guys are going to run the football, and they do it pretty doggone well. 2nd and 5. Right here, 11:29 to go here in the first quarter. This is the initial drive of the game. Once again, Genoa will go employ another 3-by-2 set. Quarterback draw, that's a design quarterback draw, and they'll be upended and had nothing doing. This time on the stop will be number 59, Clay Batten.
Maybe got one.
I'm going to call it no gain. It's going to be 3rd and 5. Big third down right here for the Otsego Knights defense. Spread again, 3-by-2 set. Bronkhorst, quick drop, nothing there, pulls it down, goes to a secondary receiver. It'll be Messenger, it'll be caught, it'll be a first down.
Well, this is going to be the first one down on the field. Rick Cam right there, watch this.
But look at the pull down right here, second read, third read. He comes back to him, he knows his check down is right there. That shows you right there, Mike, that this kid understands the entirety of this offense. He went first read, he went second read, and he knew Messenger's check down was right there, came right back to him. Great job.
Like in this game so far, if you're a Genoa fan.
And here you go, wing T, inside handoff. The hole will be plugged. First man there will be number 30. That'll be Lee Borders. Borders plugged that hole nicely for the Knights defense. We got a flag on the play. And we're going to see, what is it? Preliminary call is a legal procedure, but let's check the referee. It's exactly what we're going to get. So that's going to push the Comets back 5 yards, and we'll be first and 15.
Mm.
Exactly what you don't want, Mike, if you're a Comet, because the offense is starting to roll good, and you're staying ahead of the chains, and now you get behind the chains. See what you can dial up offensively.
Got to thank all my cold cameramen tonight. It's so nice having three cameras out here for you, buddy.
Because
yeah, I know you get into it. You enjoy it.
Yeah, you're in camera ham today. Here we go again. 3x2 set. Bronkhorst, he'll take the snap. Quick drop. Five-step drop. Oh, crossing pattern over the middle. Complete. Beat number 15. It'll beat Alex Spencer.
Do you want to see that again?
Oh, I absolutely want to see that one again. Here you go. Drag route right across the middle. Look at that. Back foot hits.
Boom.
Bam. Ball out. Nice play right there. Aiden Bronkhorst.
They seem to be able to make a lot of things happen in that middle right now. That middle linebacker is having a tough night so far.
Well, what they're doing is it looks like they're playing a lot of zone defenses. And what the 3x2 sets does is it puts stress on your back end. Zone read. It's going to be inside handoff and nothing doing as the Knights defense stiffen up.
Watch again.
Just a quick handoff on the middle, quick hitter.
Did what they needed to that time.
And this is where the Comets front line really get after you, especially on the left side of that offensive line. Caleb Giddis and number 73, John Schenever. These guys are out here, man, just mauling people. And they run to the left side again. Great clear out block. And right on cue, Braden Bryden steps in for a Genoa Bank touchdown.
There you go, buddy.
Boy, left side just clears out. You see the kick out block, kick down, block down, messenger blocks down. Nicely done.
Incredible. Just, you know, this offensive line, you said it a long time ago. You know, they just can get a lot of things done. Does that remind you of when you used to play?
Sometimes. Agnes, extra point is up, and it's good. So 8:52 into the first quarter. The Genoa Comets strike first. You're watching the High School Game of the Week right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank.
Back at Jim Firestone Field at Genoa Bank Stadium, I'm your boy, the Real Sports Guy, Steve Taylor, bringing you all in action alongside Mike Jamison.
Pleasure, my friend.
And, Mike, a pretty impressive opening drive for the Genoa Comets.
Well, what we got to see there is what we knew we were going to see. It was a balanced offense. It was a balanced drive, and they did a little bit of everything. And Otsego's going to – you know, they're explosive, though, Steve. So we're gonna see some good offense once they take the field.
Absolutely, yeah. It's your serve now, Otsego and company. We get to see what Devin Farley and company can bring to the table. This is gonna push back number 12, Lamp, and he spins around. That was actually number 10. That was Jordan Lee Barnett, and Barnett was corralled and. Massinger cut down there, knocking him down at about the 19-yard line. And, boy, man, that's not ideal starting location. First and 10 from the 18, and to be exact.
Well, both of these teams are so explosive. And we saw that Achilles heel, I think, with Otsego here with their defense. And that middle section is Genoa is able to eat that up. And I hope for them that they'll be able to make some changes there so that works out well for them.
Devin Farley, he gets to start at the quarterback. He's a very talented junior quarterback. 5 and he's going to take it on a straight quarterback drop keeper. And he'll try that right side, and he'll plow across and pick up about 4 yards.
Well, look at this, Steve.
Maybe five. But look at the blocking on the outside. Good blocking.
Yeah, they were able to make something out of nothing on that one.
Yeah. Well, they outflanked him. I tell you, a name you're going to hear a lot, hear me call a lot, is Jackson Jeremy. Jeremy, they run to his side. He's a mauler over there, 6 foot, 225. Direct snap. I mean, it'll be an inside handoff and plowing, trying that left side of the Genoa defense was Tyler Michael. But I tell you, that Comet defense was up to task there, and it's going to bring up a third down situation, third and five. And this is a big third down situation for Otsego. The last thing you want to do, Mike Jamison, is go three and out.
Well, especially after Genoa just came down there and calmly scored a touchdown. You know, that you're entirely right. And if they're able to do something now, it's got to happen right now.
It's a 3-by-1 set. And Vollmer in the running back.
And I think he got it.
And you know what? And it was all Blake Steele. Blake Steele was in the backfield. He comes out, just does a circle route out of the backfield, and he looks like he was stopped. Short of it, he just plants his foot in the ground and sticks his head, goes straight ahead and picks up the first down. Man, that was a huge first down.
That's what they needed, and that's a confidence builder for the Knights and makes them realize, okay, yeah, we can do this.
3-by-1 set once again. Throw to the outside, smoke screen, complete to number 7. That'll be Jack Lines.
Yeah, they got 5-6 out of that.
And that's what you want to do. You want to keep the Genoa defense off balance. You really don't want to let them get a bead on what you're trying to do offensively, because these guys, man, to get after you. They'll flip the formation this time. They'll go 3 wides out to the right-hand side. And he'll look that way, and he'll complete that way, drilling and completing the number 2. That'll be Kenton Wallace.
Well, watch this. That's exactly what Genoa did. You know, take advantage of the middle, and they were able to make something good happen out of that. Great job.
Boy, goes to his first read right there in the slot. Real comfortable throwing in the slot. This time they'll go 2-by-2 in a spread out the Comet offense, the defense. Inside handoff.
Oh.
Breaking a tackle and keeping his footing and going down the sideline and being knocked down after a big gain was number 10, Jordan Lee Barrett.
Well, Barnett. Like we always say, here you go, Steve.
But look at the blocking on the outside. Look at setting the edge over there was number 6. That was Jack Simpson. Simpson sets the edge, and he allows him to get to that outside. And, man, once he breaks a tackle, boy. Here's another outside smoke screen. Complete again the lines. And you see,
that going to be a first down, Steve?
It's going to be, looks like it's going to be just short of the first down. It's going to be second down and about 2. And I think we're doing a good job at making the Comet defense guess exactly what he wants to do. This time, Farley empty the backfield. Almost got a Comet to jump, but getting back on sides was number 65, Andrew Zapala.
He got it.
Inside run, and that's going to be enough to move the chains. Just the kind of drive that Otsego needed. An answer, and they're putting together quite an impressive answer, Mike Jamison.
Well, that's exactly what they do. They're multiple folds here with this offense, and what they're able to do is utilize them outside runs, and that's something Genoa's got to work on.
4:56 to go here in the first quarter. The Comets lead it 7-0, but the Otsego Knights have a little something going. They're in the red zone. Direct quarterback keeper. Design run. He'll try the left side. He'll be upended after a gain of about 3, maybe 4. Going to give him 3 yards on that, so it'll be 2nd and 7. You know, Devin Farley, a dual-threat quarterback, come in to tonight with 958 yards passing, 5 touchdowns. He had over 300 yards rushing, so he's going to give you some of everything, Mike.
Oh, you know. In so far, you know, I'd like to see a few more passes out of Otsego here and, you know, utilize that middle like they were doing earlier. But there, I think you're going to see pass here.
Overload on the right side. He's going to look right. He's going to throw right. Throws high and is broken up at the last minute by the Genoa Commons defense.
Great job by the Genoa defense right there, too. You'll see it right
Carter,
there.
Carter Lamp was the intended receiver, and coming over, breaking on the ball nicely was R.J. Atkins.
That's what you got to do, man. Not that I would know. They never throw me the ball. Go get us some water. We need a little water here, boy.
Second and 10 from the Commons. They'll go twins and pistol. Daniel B. Barnett.
Farley, he'll take hand to Barnett. Barnett will try to the left side. He'll get to the left side, and he'll move the chains. Hard run to the left side. They really did a good job at out-flanking the Comet defense on that offering, Mike.
Well, and look what you got. You got first and goal. That's exactly what they wanted out of that, and were able to make some really good things happen.
3:45 to go here in this first quarter. Genoa scored on its first drive, and Otsego is answering the bell on his first. First and goal. Inside handoff, up the middle. Bounces to the outside.
Got it.
And getting to the end zone for Genoa, another Genoa Bank touchdown. This will be Tyler Michael.
And you watch this, too. There's your blocking for you, buddy.
Yeah, did you see him pull
sure.
the guard, number 70? That would be Tyler O'Brien. Tyler O'Brien gets all the way to the edge, Mike, and he just sets him up, stands his man up, allows Michael to bounce to the outside and score the touchdown. Man, we line up for the extra point. It'll be number 27, Bruce Shaber. And that, it'll be low and no good. So 3:25 to go, first quarter. Genoa Commons cling to a one-point lead, 7-6. Ooh, you're watching High School Game of the Week right here on the Toledo Sports Network. Genoa, as the Comets play host to the Otsego Knights. Alongside Mike Jamison, I'm Steve Taylor. Glad you could join us. And Mike, we've had fireworks to start this one. The Comets go down, they score their first offensive possession, and the Knights, not to be outdone, go down and they score. So, wow.
And, you know, I think Genoa got down there a little quicker, and it seemed like it was a smoother transition for them all the way down on their first offensive parlay there. But Otsego figured out a way to do it, and, you know, they really opened the playbook on that one.
Yeah, it's going to be a short kick.
Oh, I got a second. I want to get some thanks out, of course, to our great sponsors, Genoa Bank, Maumee Bay Turf, Tas Electronics. These people have just taken such good care of us through all of this. And some of our other sponsors that work with us, Genoa Jewlers, Genoa Custom Interiors. Matter of fact, Genoa Custom Interiors is going to be working with me on a big project coming up here. I think we're getting a timeout or...
I don't not see.
Oh, they're going to re-kick it.
They're going to re-kick it. I've lost my monitor up here, so I really can't tell you.
You did?
I lost monitor.
Did it turn off? Or?
It's I have no power up here.
There's a little button on the side. Just flip that button up, and it'll turn on. Of course, you know, it's a piece of my equipment, so 9 times out of 10, it's not going to work anyway. Because I'm good down here, so.
Well, and this time he'll drive it back deeper, taking it at the 25-yard line. It'll be Genoa, and being knocked down at just short of the 40-yard line. We'll call it the 38-yard line.
Some of our other sponsors helping us out here. Scott Winkowski, attorney at law. Dear friend, he's on our radio show on Saturday mornings, the ESPN, the sports show that sucks. And we'll be over at Pro Golf Fairways right next to Nick and Jimmy's tomorrow from 8 to 10. Unless you're, if you're watching this on TV, well, then you won't because, well, it's already gone. So
spread. Short drop, five-step drop for Broncos. He'll look right, throw that way, and complete to Messenger for a gain of about 12.
Yeah, I got to show that one again. The time he is getting right now to throw that ball and with such precision to three guys guarding him is just incredible.
Yeah, well the thing that you got to pay attention to, Mike, is the fact that he's getting rid of the ball so fast.
Yeah. You let me know if you still don't have camera up there.
I still don't have anything up here.
Okay.
Outside handoff, Messenger. He'll try to get to the outside, and not having it is the Otsego defense. Wow.
Well, they brought the house that time, and they brought the house right to where they were putting the apple pies out because it was right there and was able to stop that for no gain.
And they'll spread them out again. This time they'll go 3x2. The three will be to the right. He'll look right. Come back left. Flushed out of the pocket. Broncos will throw left. Incomplete. Boy, great coverage downfield by the Otsego defense.
Well, once again, though, you know, he had tons of time. He had tons of time. And you know, kudos out to the Knights. They had everything in the secondary covered. And that was just really good.
Well, they once again, they'll go to two deep safeties this time. It's another 3x2 set employed. Five-step drop by Broncos. He'll throw in the seam and complete to Messenger once again. This will be for a gain of about 13.
Well, he found him that time, and it was open. And that's what they've been able to get to. Like you were saying, they went in that two safety drop, and they took advantage of it.
Exactly. When the two safeties drop too far, man, you know, at some point, man, you're going to have to man up. And I'm going to see, man, if they choose to man up. But right now they're playing a lot of nickel, and these guys are sitting into the soft spots of the zones, finding a man. And, you know, you get guys like Messenger who understands this offense fully. You know, he's really going to give you a good target he did right there. Genoa looked to run to the right. Messenger, he runs into a wall.
Same wall. That's the second time they were able to do that. And you just see it. They load it up. And you'd think, though, does he have the ability? He has the ability to call a different play, yes?
Or, well, you know, once you're under center, that's pretty much it, you know. You know, I think as when you see him more so in the spread, you may get a play change. But once you get up on the center, these guys got a play and they're pretty much going to run it. They're probably going to run to the left again this time. They'll look left, pitch left, trying to get to the left, and out flocking them is the Knights defense. They saw it coming, you know.
Yep. Well,
and that's the tendency to run that way because the offensive line is really stacked on that side.
Well, they were able to get there, converge on that, and, you know, three guys, boom, boom, boom. And it's great defense by the Otsego Knights. They've just not been able to do too much on this drive so far since they got to this area.
They'll go running formation real tight bunch. Turn, handoff, Messenger, he'll try the left side, and he'll successfully do so as the Knights rip off another big run.
Well, that was some great running right there, and I apologize, had a little problem with that one there. But that's where, when he can get his feet set like that and push off, nobody can stop him.
Well, good push on the left side of that offensive line.
Let's see what they can do here.
Bronkhorst under center. He'll turn. He'll hand. Oh. This time it'll be 27.
Fumble.
And it'll be a fumble. And it looks like Otsego may have it. It's Aiden Autry.
Yeah, we're starting
Andrew
to hear that.
Drops it, and Johnny on the spot is the Otsego defense. So,
big
turnover right there for Otsego.
Boy, dropped it right into Otsego's hands, though. He was losing it, and he was trying to hold on to it, and he just couldn't get it. Just couldn't get it. First turnover of the game.
Boy, this could be the way that the Otsego offense was flourishing in that first series. Let's see if they can take the turnover and make the Comet defense pay for it. They'll spread about all over the field. They'll go 3-by-1. Farley, he'll take. He'll pitch. Barnett, he'll try the left side. And unsuccessfully as the Comet defense gets over there in a hurry and throws him for a loss.
Looks like the end of the quarter there.
That's going to be it for one quarter in. And the Genoa Comets, they're clinging to a one-point lead. It's our high school game of the week. You're watching high school football right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Technical difficulty over there.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with this.
We'd like to thank Amplex Internet for providing broadband access. See the Genoa Press Box. Amplex is a Northwest Ohio-based internet service provider that provides affordable, reliable broadband internet access to thousands of households and businesses throughout Northwest Ohio. Since 1997, their goal is to provide broadband internet service to areas with the largest providers since the last registration. Local support, regular fees, and no pricing games. Please visit our website.
Yeah, I can't see nothing.
www.amplex.net for more information. Also, a reminder for every sack your comments report tonight, St. John Lutheran Church in Winston. You can donate your $25 sack of groceries to the Genoa Food Pantry. Thank you to St. John Lutheran Church in Winston.
Welcome back to the start of the second quarter. Alongside Mike Jameson, I'm Steve Taylor, bringing you all the action. Farley, quick drop. He'll complete as he throws to the right for a short gain as the Genoa defense swarms to the spot. They come up with it. It's going to bring up a third and long. Third and 12. Big situation for the defense of the Genoa Comets. They can come up with it after the turnover. Farley in a 3-by-1. Sends a man in motion. He'll look right. Pulls it down, has his great defense and sacked by the Genoa defense. Carson Wallman in on the side. Great job by the Genoa defense. Really, really holding up on the back end and allowing the rush man to get there. Bringing up a fourth down. So punting situation for the Otsego Knights.
Cohen back to punt.
All right, he sends it straight up in the air. Not a long, not a far punt at all. As he somewhat shanked it, it's going to be kicked out of bounds at the 36-yard line of the Otsego Knights. So a real short punt that sets up the Knights in pretty good position. So basically, they pick up where they left off and they get to start it all over again. Bronkhorst brings the offense out.
Counts will take over possession at the Knight
35-yard line. First and 10, Genoa at the 35-yard line. Broncos under center. They'll go jumbo. He'll turn. He'll hand. Try the right side. Messenger breaks a tackle and drags two men with him. Make it three men. As he crosses the 30, drags two tacklers, would-be tacklers, for a gain of six.
Stop made by Tyler Michael. Second and four.
Boy, that's some run. You talk about determination there. But Messenger stopped dead to right in the hole, and he continued to drag would-be tacklers. Wing T, Bronkhorst under center. He'll turn. He'll hand straight ahead. Bouncing it outside to be Autry. And picking up a first down and much more. And getting into the red zone is the Genoa Comet offense.
Did it drop?
And Bronkhorst brings him up. He's under center. Wing T. Toss to the left side. Clearing out that left side is Guinness and company. But a quarterback comes up and knocks him down. Farley picks up a gain of about four. We're going to call it four. We'll call it second down and six. Bronkhorst under center. Looks over the defense, surveys it. He'll turn, hand to the left side. That's a great fake. Looks like a flag comes in late. We're going to preliminary indication is offsides. Let's see what it's going to be.
I couldn't tell what he was doing. He went like this. He went to his waist.
We got a good personal foul chop block.
This is a personal foul chop block against the Comets.
Oh, there you go.
So that's going to move. That's going to cost the Comets about 15 yards on this one as we sort it all out. This is going to be a big one as they were driving. So we're going to get a personal foul chop block against Genoa, and that's going to move them back to the 28-yard line. And spreading them out once again. Bronkhorst, he surveys. Five-step drop. Drag route complete. Messenger makes a man miss in space. Gets to the edge. Drags another man up. What determination by Robert Messenger. The safety valve, just understanding the offense is Aiden Bronkhorst, knowing where your check down is. Check down is not bad, and he does it in that instance. And just like that, it's going to bring up third and very manageable for the Genoa offense.
Do you love me now?
Absolutely. 8:21 to go here in this second quarter. Inside handoff. It'll be Messenger. It'll be plugged up by the Knights defense. Very stingy on the defensive side of the ball. It's going to be just short of the yard to gain Mike Jameson. That's going to bring up fourth down and decision time for the Genoa Comets.
Are we looking at fourth and goal?
It's fourth and one for the first down.
Gotcha. I had to go upstairs. There are a couple of guys complaining that some of my system didn't work. So, heck yeah, they're going to go for it.
He's going to take it himself, and he may have been stood up. It's going to be interesting to see where the spot is. Good surge right there by the Knights. But Bronc Horse does it all himself. He calls his own number, Mike.
Well, let's see if we got that one. We sure did. Look at this.
You see him spin away from the contact, and the 6-4 frame falls forward for the first down.
Boy, I'll tell you what, too. He is a truck. Absolute truck. He's just built so big, and he can just do things that.
Inside handoff, left side.
That's a touchdown.
And it's Aiden Antry once again. Antry with a Genoa Bank touchdown.
I didn't get that one. I was working on something here. I apologize. I got one fast on me here.
Left side of the offensive line for the Genoa Comet flies off the football, opening up, pushing the defense back into the end zone, allowing Antry to do what he does. The extra point is up, and it is good. So 7:21 to go here in the second quarter. Genoa leads this one 14-6. You're watching high school football right here on the Toledo Sports Network. Back at Genoa High School on a beautiful Friday night for football. Alongside Mike Jamison, I'm your boy, the real sports guy, Steve Taylor, bringing you all the action. Our high school game of the week, the 4-3 Genoa Commons, playing host to the 5-2 Otsego Knights. And, Mike, we have not been disappointed at all.
Oh, heck no. You know, the one thing that you've seen out of both of these teams is the fact that, you know what, we really still have something to prove. And numbers in the playoffs, the way it's going to set them up, this game is so important. And it's just nice to see just blood and guts football here.
Yeah, the winner of this game probably will make the playoffs. And we're seeing both of the teams put forth great effort as the kick is driven deep, taken by Barnett, and he'll be upended at the 17-yard line by the special teams of the Comets.
Well, you know, and that's something we haven't talked a lot about with either one of these teams so far, Steve, but, you know, special teams, I think, is what's going to be the monstrous difference when we come down at the end of this game.
And a great point, Mike, because the special teams is what set up the short field for Genoa to score their last touchdown.
Exactly. I wouldn't know because I was trying to get a TV monitor to work.
Well, you know, that's part of your job.
You love me, brother. Yeah, I just put a little power supply in the wrong spot. I've done that a couple of times in my life.
Yeah,
you know,
things that are done, do it with all your might. Things that's done half is never done right. Farley, he'll take handoff inside and being shut down off was 52. Donnie Tolowski. Tahoski
is a hard one to say.
Well, Tahoski is a baller, man. They move him all over the front of that defensive line, Mike. They try to find matchups for Tahoski, and we saw him exploit a lot of different matchups last week. He exploited that one right there for a loss. Second and 12. Quick drop. Farley, he'll complete. This one will be his favorite receiver, Jack Simpson.
No, I don't think he completed it.
Nope. Yeah, it looked like he dropped. He dropped it at the last minute.
I didn't get to see that one. I apologize, but every once in a while.
Boy, that's going to set up a third and long, and here we go.
Third and 10?
Third and 12. Mm. Interesting to see what.
I mean, what are you doing this? You're way back.
Well, you spread them out and try to catch a crossing route, and that's what they're going to do. They're going to move the pocket to get him extra time. Throw, couldn't complete on the outside as he was looking for his number one man, Jack Simpson. You see, you move the pocket, Mike. You try to get him extra time to try to find a soft spot in the zone. And Simpson had found that soft spot. He's got to catch that one, Mike.
That's a tough catch, though. He's moving. The ball's coming from away from him. That is probably one of the tougher catches to make.
That's going to bring up a fourth and 12. And here we go.
Hey, you got to get started thinking about your Taylor Automotive player of the game, unsung hero.
And there we go. Much better punt as he sticks his foot into this one. It's going to take him a bounce, a Otsego bounce out of bounds in Otsego territory. Excuse me. And it's going to bring first and 10 for the Genoa Comets at its own 48-yard line. So the Genoa offense back in business. They can double dip here, Mike, because, you know, they do have to kick off to Otsego to start the second half. So, you know, idealistically, you like to get your offense something going and try to push one across before the half.
Well, right now we got to see what Otsego's defense is made of. This is it right here. And this is where they have to make a statement. And they've been making some pretty good statements.
Well, they have. And you see right now what they do, Mike, is they take and they put a single safety high. So what they're doing is they're sneaking that safety up to the line of scrimmage to try to control the line of scrimmage. You're right there. Good play. It's going to bring up second and long. But I tell you, you've got eight men in that box, man. That's going to be tough sledding. Good luck unless you outflank them.
If you're at Otsego right now, this is right where you got to do it, and they can. I mean, they have definitely got the ability. Look at that. That was a scrum right there. I mean, everybody was there.
Boy, did you see number 70, O'Brien, who just came up? Watch how he's being held right here, but he blows that up. But what they're doing, Mike, it's 10 men in the box, man. Good luck running on that.
Good job, Otsego.
It's going to bring up third and long, and here is the big moment for the Otsego defense at 5:14. Can they get off the field right here? Genoa's look to spread them out, 3-by-2 set. Quick drop, five-step drop. Being flushed out of pocket is Bronkhorst. He's going to try to take off and get to the sticks. He'll get there. Enough for the first down, and he'll scamper out of bounds after about a 15-yard gain.
That's the first time where he's had the ability to do that. Everything was blocked up real nice for him, and he just saw the opening, and he took it.
Well, if you look at it, Mike, number 59 took a bad angle for Otsego. He was the spy, Mike. He sat too far inside. He's got to get outside, Mike, to try to contain him, to keep him inside. And I'm talking about Caden Bronkhorst. Bronkhorst, he'll spread him out again. He'll throw. To the right, complete to the right. It'll be Antry, and Antry will drag a tackler as the clock keeps moving. Tick, 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 tick.
You got a little fluster there, boss. Sometimes.
Antry be just short of a first down. That was going to be like about a 9-yard gain. We'll call it
second one. There you go.
.425 to go here before the half. Bronkhorst under center. He'll turn. He'll hand left side entry. He'll move the chains. But he'll be stacked up after a short gain.
Yeah, once again, you know, it's the big boys up front making all that happen.
Well, good job at Giddes blocking down. You're taking your pull, your guard.
Right.
To get to the next lever.
That's first down.
That's going to move the chains. First down. And Genoa goes jumbo again. They come out. Bronkhorst under the center.
Well,
He'll turn, hand straight ahead. Entry, breaks a tackle, and tripped up just before he makes a house call.
Wow.
Well, I tell you right there, boy, you see him there, boy. He started to see pay dirt. And, boy, they nice job at Otsego to trip him up just before he gets that head of steam. But it's enough for a first down, 3:30 to go before the half. And Genoa in no hurry, Mike Jamison.
Well, and why should you be? You're able to, you know, you're running the show right now when it comes to taking it up the middle.
Double A got bits. They run it to the outside, breaks to the outside, and Antrie will be cut down after a gain of about three, maybe. We'll call it four. Second and six.
You know, we're just so happy we're able to do all these games. And great people like Graymont and Genoa, Genoa Custom Interiors, Genoa Jewlers, of course, Genoa Bank helping us out. We appreciate it. You know, we were kind of scheduled to tonight. We were supposed to do the Eastwood game out at Rossford.
Thank you.
It would have been cold. It would have been cold.
Bronkhorst under center. He'll turn. He'll find Antry. Antry will spin and be denied. It's coming over there to knock him down. It's number 30. That'll be Lee Borders.
Now, you see, that is great defense right there. He stopped him and didn't stop once he stopped him, and they were able to push him back. And a great job by Otsego right there.
Excellent pad level right there by Borders.
I couldn't have done any better in there. You know, I was always the big guy, the big skinny guy, so I always had to play center. You know, and I couldn't walk and chew gum, Steve. You know me. And it just wasn't pretty. I give the big guys so much credit inside.
Bronkhorst, he'll take, he'll look, he'll throw. And had a man open but couldn't complete it as he tried to find number 9, Denver Stewart. Had his tight end out in the flat, Mike, but he just – couldn't connect it.
I don't know if we got this or not, but I'll tell you, that Otsego defender did a nice job to stop him when he started to make his cut, and it took the timing off right there. And that's, you know, that's great secondary defense right there to, you know, make it tough for him to move to get him to his spot. And you know, quarterback's only got so much time, and it's all a timing pattern.
And that's going to bring up the fourth down, so they're good. The Comets are going to have to kick it, so good job by – Otsego, the kick is up, and it is no good. So a big stop by Otsego, turning away a scoring opportunity by the Knights. 1:44 to go here before the half. Genoa leads it 14-6.
If you're looking for fantastic Italian food along with old world hospitality and family traditions, DiStasio's is your place. Located in Elmore, Ohio, Coach Mike DiStasio and his family have become a fast favorite with pizza, lasagna, and other great old world Italian dishes. Stop out today or call them at 419-862-0404. DiStasio's, 351 Rice Street in Elmore, Ohio.
.146 to go here in the second quarter, and a big stop by Otsego. Inside handoff, it'll be Barnett. He'll try to the right side unsuccessfully as he'll be knocked down,
Steve,
after a short kick carry, a gain of one.
And that is the point where I think they should utilize that middle again. You know, in the first down, second down, when you're backed up there, I think Otsego needs to take advantage of the middle just like Genoa was doing.
Well, that wasn't there. Pulling it down was Farley, when you see the double threat quarterback really doing a good job at understanding his read wasn't there. You saw how fast he pulled it down, Mike, and took off.
Well, and, you know, just what we were talking about, you know, the boys up front got to do their job to give him another 2 seconds so that that play can develop.
Third down and four. A short four. We'll call it a long three.
There you go.
Farley, he'll spread them out. He'll throw, and not connecting with Kenton Wallace.
What are they? Are they calling that a forward pass?
No, it was not a fumbled. It was a pass.
Yeah.
And he just didn't catch it. Incomplete pass.
Oh, good thinking there to make sure that he covers it up, even though it didn't matter.
Yeah. So Otsego, 41 seconds. They're going to have to punt it away.
Back to receive the punt for the Comets, number 24, Robert Messenger.
Messenger back to receive the punt. It'll be Joshua Terry. Terry has sent it deep, boy, under a heavy rush. Sends it back deep. It'll take a night bounce and go out of bounds at about the 41-yard line, maybe 42. So Genoa has 33 seconds to try to get something done. Mike, do you take a knee or do you spread them out?
You know, you just don't know what Genoa. You know, obviously we've been doing a lot of Genoa games and seen a lot of what they've been able to do, but nothing surprises me from Genoa anymore.
Well, looking at the package that they have out there, it looks like they're going to spread them out, and that's exactly what they're going to do. They're going to go 3-by-2. A lot of confusion on the defense for Otsego. Completing and throwing and completing short to number 15, Alex Spencer, was Bronkhorst. But that's just a pitch and catch. I mean, that's just understanding what the defense is giving you, Mikey. You want to give me 7, I'll take it.
He's got the arm. He can throw it. So.
Yeah, Bronkhorst can definitely throw the deep out.
And I think that's what's going to wind up happening here if they get into a third down situation. Oh, he's going.
And it's going to be, looks like that's going to be another catch.
Wow, I got to check that one out again. Let's see what that one looks like here.
It's going to be, they're going to call that incomplete on the outside. Let's see if Spencer pull that down.
Oof. Yep.
That could have fooled me. I thought he caught it.
Well, let's see right now.
The third down. And pulling it down and running, it'll be Aiden Bronkhorst putting his foot in the ground. Boy, giving a little wiggle.
I'm telling you, he when he starts running, it's kind of weird looking, but, man, is he good. He's got some feet, man.
But he understands. Look, it sticks his foot in the ground right there. Right, once again. All positive yardage.
Yeah, and he made something out of nothing, really, you know, where thought he was going to get smacked on that one.
And they'll take time out.
Let's go timeout.
And we'll take timeout with them. 19 seconds to go. Genoa leads it 14-6.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Back at Jim Firestone Field at Genoa Bank Stadium, I'm the Real Sports Guy, Steve Taylor. Please, you could join us. Mike Jamison also on the call, double duty, bringing you all of the replays and everything.
Trying.
First down, and we've got a spread going on here. Bronkhorst, short drop. He'll look over the middle. Tried to find Aiden Antry and throws a bit high. Genoa trying to get chunks right now, Mike.
What are we looking at? First and 10, second and 10?
Second down and 10 at the 35-yard line. 15 seconds to go. Autry blitz. This time he steps up into the teeth of the blitz. Looking, it's waves a man down the field. Nope. He's going to pull it down and run for himself. He picks up 10, 15 yards and gets out of bounds at the 20-yard line. 6 seconds to go, like 1 other second. Look at him. He understands. Saw the blitz. Look at him, Mike. Step up into the teeth of the blitz right here. Motion his man to go deep. What he does is take that defender out of the play to tackle him, and he turns it up the field. That's real smart, Mike. That's cerebral football.
Wow. Good stuff right there. Got timeout. We'll be back with more right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
From the kitchens of Italy to you, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen is the home of authentic Italian food. As one of the oldest independently owned pizzerias in Toledo, Arturo's Pizza Kitchen has been serving since 1988. With pizza, salads, award-winning subs, chicken chunks and wings, mom's own lasagna recipe, and our famous cheese sticks, we have it all. Never frozen, always homemade. Arturo's Pizza Kitchen. Hungry? Call Arturo's, 419-698-1641.
So the decision has been made. 5 seconds to go on this one. And the Genoa Comets will try a 35-yard field goal to extend his lead. High snap. It's brought down. It's blocked by the Knights. They look to pick it up, and they cover it. And that's going to do it for the first half. So one half in our Toledo Sports Network High School Game of the Week. The Genoa Comets lead it 14-6. We're going to step aside, and we're going to bring you much, much more. Thanks for joining us. You're watching high school football right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Stop struggling with the big box stores. Choose Gladio. Gladio Home
Center. A hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned. You'll be glad to know, Gladio, Gladio Home Center.
Girl. Back for the start of the second half. Alongside Mike Jamison, I'm the Real Sports Guy, Steve Tilley, bringing you all the action from inside Jim Firestone Field on the campus of Genoa Bank Stadium. First half totals, Genoa 242 total yards. They had 129 rushing, 113 passing. Otsego 75 total yards.
Oh.
Up ended at the 25-yard line is Barnett. Farley in the first half, 5 out of 9 for 29 yards.
I'm listening to our stream right now. It sounded pretty good.
It sounded pretty strong.
And, I always like getting props out. And, Genoa Bank has gotten me through World War III. You know, I've spent $3,200 on three of my cars between new brake lines, wow. New alternators. And Marty Sutter and them really did some great financing for me, and I can't thank them enough.
And here we go. Second half. First snap, it'll be Farley. He'll turn. He'll hand inside handoff and dragging defenders over to the 20-yard line. It'll be Thaddon Temko.
Once again, what we were talking about earlier in the game, Steve, do something explosive on that first play in your series and experiment a little bit with that. They've always the last two or three times down, they've done that same run, right up off the left-hand side, and really they haven't been able to do anything with that.
A lot of zone read what they're getting right now, and what you're going to go is shotgun. And we're going to go zone read again. Inside handoff Barnett. He'll break a tackle. And he'll get out close to a first down. It'll be short. It'll be third and about three.
There's a hole there, and they were able to utilize it and get three out of it.
But good job at firing off initially. But here you go again. Third and manageable for Otsego, and this is exactly how they started the game on their initial drive when they scored their touchdown. They're going to have to dig in and try to find a way to get it done. He'll keep
there it.
Gets to the outside. He'll break a tackle and get
nice.
Out to the 45-yard line.
First time he's been able to do that tonight, Steve. And look at just that's all him. Nice job. Oh, got a little yellow on the field.
Yeah, a little laundry on it. And when you see the applause right there by number 85, Harshenfucker, it's like, let's go back the other way. No, actually, that was Tucker Fredrickson.
9 times out of 10, that's a hold, eh?
Yeah, it's in the area of holding. But
Steve, I got to tell you this. We've got the best cameramen tonight. Aren't they all doing a great job?
All over. Those guys are doing a great job.
I mean, it's like watching
That's
Monday Night Football.
It's going to be unsportsmanlike conduct against Otsego. So the first down should remain because this was a dead ball foul. And so we see the referee a little unsure. Dead ball. It's going to be a first down. Now, my question is it going to be first and 10, or is it going to be first and 15? And it will be first and 10. So they'll move the chains accordingly, and then they'll move them backwards accordingly. So there you go.
I don't know.
In event, it's going to be first down for Otsego.
I'm not putting any numbers down. We'll see it there.
First down, quick drop, throw, complete on the outside. It'll be Jack Simpson.
See what I was telling you? They're able to utilize that outside stuff now. And so Genoa's going to have to start covering that.
Well, it's been there all night, Mike. They just haven't been doing it, especially on throwing downs. We saw them drop a couple of passes on the outside earlier tonight. But that's just a good pitch and catch right there. Otsego, they'll spread them out again. Farley, he'll turn. He'll throw. Complete.
Oh, nice tackle.
Great open field tackle right there by number 85, Tucker Fredrickson. The linebacker comes up and really lays wood.
Well, they blitzed going up the left side, and I thought it was going to hurt Genoa right there. And I thought maybe Otsego would have seen that because, there was – quite an opening if they would have taken it up the middle a little bit there. But I'll tell you, good game so far.
Another big third down. This will be third and four.
No matter who we're rooting for.
Inside handoff. Door was closed, but
got
turning
it.
And going on his own and picking up the first down was Blake Steele. Man, that was all Mr. Steele.
Yeah, and what he was able to do is find a hole in there that hasn't been there in a while. So that's good run right there. Yeah,
keep those legs turning, Mike. And that's what he did right there. Really kept those legs going. The initial offering was shut down, but still kept his legs going, moving the chains for Otsego. So another first down. They'll roll Farley out. He'll turn. He'll throw. He'll complete. And this time that target will be number six, it'll be Jack Steele, and you've seen right now.
Three in a row on
that
side.
Opening up the offense.
Yep.
You want to give us that little that soft coverage on the outside, we'll exploit it.
Well, it's almost like watching an Ohio State game. First half, they don't do anything like that, and the second half, they blow it up. Second and two.
Yeah, we'll go 3-1 this time. A pistol in the pistol still. He'll take from the pistol. He'll break over to the left side, right side, and he'll move the chains again on a strong run, finishing nicely.
Got his first down, too.
First and 10 on the 40 from the 43-yard line. 8:43 to go here in the third quarter. Quick smoke screen complete on right side to Jake Limes.
They're moving the ball real quick right now. We got an injury on the field.
And that's going to be Mason Rowe that's down.
We'll take a quick timeout.
Well, he's down. We'll take timeout. You're watching high school football right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Graymont and Genoa, producers of dochlamide, lime, and hydrate, serving the community for over 90 years. The plant currently has 60 employees. The safety and development of these employees is a focus for your plant. Over 80% of our employees currently live within 11 miles of the plant. Graymont. For more information about this company, you can check us out on the web at www.graymont.com.
Well, welcome back to Jim Firestone Field. I'm Steve Taylor, the Real Sports Guy, bringing you all the action along with Mike Jamison.
What would I be if you're the Real Sports Guy?
I don't know. I don't know.
Hey, talk a little bit about your podcast that
every
you got.
Every Saturday mornings, man. Yeah, on my YouTube channel, Steve's TV. That's Stevez, small z. Man, we've got the voice of the Cleveland Cavaliers. Tim Alcorn. He'll be on, and he'll be giving us all things that are Cleveland Cavalierish. That'll be tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock.
Right after my show.
Right after your show.
I appreciate you doing that at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, that's how we do. That's how we rock, man.
I know.
Because, man, we're going to have to get you in on that, man. You know,
and we got to get you into doing, you know, these games air on CW 13.2 at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning. And then they air again on WMNT, channel 48.1, at 1 o'clock on Sundays now. So you can watch it. You got 4 hours to listen to us.
Yeah. And then we got to hook it up to when we get this thing on Steve's TV, man. We got to get that. We got to make that happen.
All right. We can do that.
The more the merrier.
There you go.
So here we go. We're back in action. It's second down and seven. Otsego on the move on the 40-yard line of the Genoa Comets. They'll spread them out. They'll go two by two.
Here they come, too.
And he'll send one in motion. That'll be Atkinson. Straight drop back, and the pocket collapses as coming up big. It's number 50. That's my guy, Caleb Gittes.
Yeah, that's an oucher. That's what's known as an oucher.
But the pocket just collapsed. Look at the pressure. The pressure by Gittes. He just takes and pushes his man into the lap of the quarterback.
Yeah, and if there's something we're going to talk about, and we've said it over and over tonight, it's the offensive line. Otsego's got to do whatever it takes to clog that middle up like that when the guys are coming.
Well, and that's consequently why they're using a lot of quick hitters and a lot of misdirection so those guys don't tee off on your offensive line, Mike.
Third and a lot, huh?
It'll be third and about 13, and it's time out on the field. They'll take time, and we will too. It's 7:36 to go. Genoa leads it 14-6.
Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa, has been serving the area with quality jewelry and gifts for over 19 years. Specializing in gold and silver repairs, Frank Comeyes has been a goldsmith for over 30 years. Our selection of Pulsar watches, Precious Moments figurines, Reflections beads, Seraphim classics, and quality Stellar rings, all at a price you can afford. Genoa Jewelers also buys gold and silver and has the perfect gift for that someone special. Stop out today at Genoa Jewelers, 611 Main Street in Genoa.
And welcome back to Friday Night Lights right here.
It's pink out night.
It is pink out night. It's senior night. It's the last home game for the Genoa Comets.
It seems like it just started. You know what I mean? It's wow.
Yeah. Man, a game that was very interesting at the half, 21-14 Eastwood over Rossford, has been extended to a 42-14 Eastwood lead. Just like that.
You were right, Steve.
Third and 13. Here we go. Farley, he'll take quick snap. He's flushed out of the pocket again and coming up with a sack. It's number 52, and that's my guy once again, Donnie Tucholsky.
I got a low one on this. They're just coming right up the middle.
That's called, hey, look, beat the man in front of you and get to the quarterback play. Meet me at the quarterback. Exactly what Genoa does, and they come up with a big third down stop.
Fourth and about?
Fourth and 18.
Okay. You know, my lighting isn't very good in here, so sometimes I miss with the numbers. I apologize, folks.
Big Kicks is going to send Messenger back. It's going to take a night bounce and be downed inside the 20 at the 19, and that's where the Comets will do business. Genoa, first half numbers, 242 yards rushing. They had 129 yards passing. Bronkhorst was 11 out of 14. 113 yards passing, 129 yards rushing. Antry had 9 carries for 50 yards. Messenger, 6 receptions for 73 yards. Spread. Bronkhorst, short drop. He'll pull it down. It's going to be a hold on the side, and he comes back to his safety valve once again. He knows where Messenger is at all times, but we're going to get holding, and let's see if we can pick it up.
Right
and
there.
I see it right there on number, 64. Looks like 73 to me. But in any event, we're going to get holding, and it's going to come back. And this is not the kind of start that the Comets wanted.
No.
It's going to be.
Oh, there you go.
First and 20?
Ooh.
Ooh. Longer than that, it's going to be first, because that's going to be a spot foul. So it's going to be from the 6-yard line. 13-yard penalty on the play. So first and 23. Brunkhorst, he'll pull it up after the snap, direct snap. Brunkhorst will break a tackle, put his head down, and get out over the 20 to the 21-yard line. Great gain. But this kid's a load coming at you. How about trying to tackle that?
Yeah, yeah. When you got feet and you're that big, that makes things pretty good for you there.
Second and 9. And the Comets have spread them out. 3-by-2. Brunkhorst, he'll drop. He'll look, swing.
Oh!
He'll hit his receiver, and his receiver be hit right away. That was Mason Drummond, and Drummond was dropped immediately.
I hate doing this one in slow motion. It hurts me to watch this. Hello. Boom.
Boy, number 59, I tell you, Clay Batten comes in from his linebacker position and battens down the hatches right there. It's going to bring up third and about 8. Brunkhorst, quick drop. He'll turn. He'll throw. It's going to be stepped in front of it, taken into the house. House call by Owen Atkinson.
Wow. He timed that absolutely perfect.
No, Mike, it was a predetermined coming out of the huddle that he was going to make that throw. You can't make that throw. He didn't look. He knew he was going to throw there, and right there he just baited him. You know, it's straight zone. They've been playing zone all night. Mike, they've been playing nickel all night. So they're sitting on those soft throws on the outside. And he finally got one, and he made a house call. They're going to go for 2, I do believe, to try to tie this thing up.
Well, once again, you know, you blow a timing pattern, that's what's going to happen. And that was a blown timing pattern. Yep. Just did. And
I mean, you can't make that throw. I mean, you know, he looked him down. He looked him down the whole way. Here we go. Big 2-point conversion. Farley, he'll take the snap. He'll go behind, bounce it outside, bounce it again, and the Genoa defense comes up big and making the stop right there. It was number 14 for the Genoa Comets, and that's Austin Teat.
You know where to go. It's been like that on that side all night.
That entire side, they continued to bounce it wide. They just wouldn't give it up. And they turn away the Knights' 2-point conversion attempt. So 5:22 to go here in the third quarter. Genoa holding on to a 14-12 lead alongside Mike Jamison. I'm Steve Taylor. Glad you could join us for our high school game of the week. And it is turning into just that, Mike Jamison. When I called you earlier, I thought we'd get the kind of game that we're getting today, tonight, and I am definitely not disappointed, sir.
Well, I got to tell you, everything that we've seen, you know, we've got the Taylor Automotive unsung hero of the game. And, I'll tell you what, there have just been so many things happening, and so many guys on both of these teams have done some great. You're impressed all the way around.
Yeah, you know that's one. Unfortunately for Genoa, that's one of those throws that if you're Aiden Brunkhorst, you like to have back.
Yeah,
you know,
it's kind of like golf. You make 7 mistakes a game when you play 18 holes. You make 7 of them.
Yeah,
and that's one of the 7.
Depends on when you make them. You know.
Exactly.
So,
but, hey, great for Otsego. They had to figure out a way to get back into this game. And, you know, it was really only a 1-score game. But Genoa, I thought, was dominating for a while. And
well, the numbers don't lie. Men lie, exactly. Women lie, numbers never lie, and the numbers don't lie. You know, Otsego needed a boost, and they got it from their defense. Right here, their special teams is coming up big, and they knocked down the ball carrier. That ball carrier was Archery. Antry was knocked down at the 30-yard line, so 5:17 to go third quarter. Genoa, 14-12, 2 turnovers for Genoa thus far tonight, and Otsego's made them pay.
And that one was really a big one for them, but because of positioning, they've had to deal with it, you know, both ways there.
And so here we go. Back to Old Faithful. Under center. Turn. Handoff.
Yeah, they got him that time.
Andrea tried that left side to no avail.
Get a couple out of it.
Simpson over there to knock him down. We're going to give him a gain of one on that. So second and nine.
I put eight. Sorry. Sue me. I don't feel like trying to dig in to do it again because I can't see anything down here. So,
so we're going to go spread. And they're showing blitzes. I see when they're going to bring Steele on the blitz.
Oh.
Boy, and sitting down in that zone right there was Alex Spencer.
I got to show you something, Steve. Watch this in slow motion. Oh, we missed it, but boy, they Otsego almost got that one too.
Yeah, the ball was tipped. That ball was tipped. I don't know if you can show that again. That ball was tipped. That's what made it. Let's call it a third and six. Bronkhorst sends his man deep, flushed out of the pocket. He'll throw back. Incomplete.
Hey, great defense by Otsego right there. They did what they needed to do, and they were on right path there and was able to stop the Comets.
Well, the defense really, really stood up well. The zones flooded them exactly well, flushed the quarterback out of the pockets, and they're going to force a fourth down punt. So here we go.
I finally turned my big fluorescent light on. I couldn't not see anything anymore.
That would help. I turned mine on first half. Messenger, they're going to get a punt. And what's going to happen is going to be too many men on the field as they try to run a man off at the last moment. And I tell you what, the Otsego press box is losing its mind over it because, Mike, this is going to be an automatic first down. They were just getting ready to get the ball back.
Way too many on the field. Well, they had 12 men on the field.
Oh, there was about 14 of them out there.
That'll do it every time. Sometimes you wonder if the refs can count, but, boy, they could count that time.
Well, yeah, you know, it didn't take a rocket scientist to figure that one out. And that's going to be a big first down for Genoa. They're going to maintain possession of the football. And it's going to be first down at from the 42-yard line. And I tell you, the Otsego coaches.
I keep hearing a banging noise up there. I'm down in the truck, so
yeah,
I don't get to hear it. But
I can tell you what it is. I can tell you exactly what it is. It's the booth of Otsego coaches.
Another flag.
This one here is going to be a pre-snap penalty. Yeah. So this one is going to go against Genoa. We're going to get motion.
Yep.
So that'll move them back 5 yards. So they gain five. So it'll be first and 15. 3:48 to go here in the third quarter. High school game of the week. Genoa leads Otsego 14-12 alongside Mike Jamison. I'm Steve Taylor, the Real Sports Guy, bringing you all of the action. Brunkhorst will spread them out. He'll send Messenger in motion, fake, and he'll keep. Try that left side, and he'll pick up the penalty yardage at least, and he'll get back maybe to the 42-yard line. So that will give us, second and 10.
Is it 10? Okay. I was going to go to 11. Amazing when you turn some lights on in here. I feel so much better.
Bronkhorst looks over the defense, surveys it. He'll take the snap. He'll pull it down. He'll run again. Stop, start. Break it to the outside. Picks up a block out there from number 12, Mason Drummond. And he's going to stretch it out, and he's going to be close to a first down.
And it was, you know, a little bit of a stutter step that he did, and it just made everything go a lot easier for him. And what are we looking at here?
It's going to be first down, first and 10 at the 45-yard line.
3:07 to go here in this third quarter. Genoa on the drive. Bronkhorst looks over the defense. He'll pull it down again. Stop, start. Lowers the shoulder and picks up the first down once again after running over two would-be tacklers.
I didn't get all of it, but look at this. It's just brute force. That kid is just strong.
That was four tackles he just went through. And Bronkhorst lowering the shoulder and starting to show his prowess. 2:45 to go here, third quarter. And the chain gang is. You know, let me ask you this, Mike. Why in the world of technology are we still using chains? I mean, can we get more prehistoric than chains?
I don't know. I don't want to get into that debate because somebody will text me and, you know.
They're going to yell
at me on the radio tomorrow from 8 to 10 on ESPN, 100, the sports show that sucks. And you laugh every time I say that. It's the greatest.
Because, you know, I work on a show that does it, you know.
But I'll bet for the Ohio State-Michigan game, you're not going to have belly dancers on there like I will.
Man,
just wanted to say that.
No, man, I've got a wife that'll kill me. No, you're right.
Good friend of mine, and they do the belly dancing for ladies. It's like a workout for them, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's really cool what they do.
Yeah, it'll be a workout all right.
You're a smart man, Mr. Taylor.
Yes, I am.
But I'm single, so I'm a smart single man.
Here we go, back to action. Genoa spreads them out. First down, Broncos, five-step drop. He'll step flushed out of pocket, finds the crosser, Messenger, and he'll be tackled by Steele in the open field. Messenger's going to be real close to another first down.
Yeah, we got a bad clip there. Every once in a while, we're getting a few of these bad clips. Maybe my 20-year-old editing system isn't working the way it should tonight.
He picks up eight on that. It'll be second and two.
Brought to you by Fred Flintstone Video Productions. I got Barney Miller on the instant replay tonight.
That's about right.
We'll try another one just for the hell of it. Yeah.
Bronkhorst, he'll send entry in motion, and he'll keep himself, put his head down.
I see another flag.
And you know what that's going to be.
Yeah, that's either a holding or
– it's going to be a motion.
Yep, sure is. That'll bring you back every time.
That'll bring you back five. It'll be second and about seven.
You know, I was talking about how much money I bought this production truck from Channel 24, and it's obviously the greatest thing in this world. But I didn't use it for a year because of COVID and everything, so every time I start it, something breaks on it now, you know. And make sure you've got jumper cables tonight, just in
case. Broncos on the center. He'll turn hand over the left side, and being stacked up his entry by a host of Knights, led by number 28, Joshua Terry.
Yeah, that was a scrum right there again. We've seen three or four of them this game. And, you know, you go up to up, and it's maybe 2 yards no matter what. Either way, Genoa or Otsego on offense.
Third down, a big third down play right here for the Genoa offense. Can the Knights defense be up to task? We'll find out. Bronkhorst under center. He'll take turn, hand left.
I think he got it.
Antria be knocked down, but he may be just short of the first down. Preliminary indication is he's just short of the first down. Let's look and see. Antria tripped up, and he is just short of that first down mark, Mike.
Well, what do you do at this point?
Well, you know what? I'm running over the left side of that offensive line. Yeah. They've been getting great push all night. I'd do it again. No guesswork involved. They'll turn, they're left. They cheated the B gap that time right there. Blitzed the A gap. Cheated on the B gap, but Antry got a good push from the left side and moved the chains.
Well, they got what they needed right there. And Otsego's got to really put it together now to hold them. We got a timeout?
No, we've got 10 seconds to go, but to end the quarter, so that's going to do it. Three quarters are in the book. Genoa leads at 14-12, and they're on the drive again. Let's come back and watch the fourth quarter of high school football right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Blackberry Corner, on the corner of 579 and Elliston Road, is a proud sponsor of Genoa football and has the best burgers, chicken, and pizza. You know the pizza. Everyone knows the pizza. Blackberry Corner also has charbroiled pork ribs and Jim's famous chicken dinners. Whether it's appetizers, pizza, or a full dinner, the great folks at Blackberry Corner can help fill you up and save you money. Stop out to Blackberry Corners on the corner of State Route 579 and Elliston Road for a meal or just a snack.
Stay tuned as we bring you our Taylor Automotive unsung hero of the game.
I'm excited about that. I don't know which way I'm going. I don't know if I'm going to be able to help you out on this one, dude. Because, both teams have been playing very well. This is a hard-fought battle both ways. And, you know, I've had a couple of people kind of text us, hey, you guys are homering for Genoa. I think, you know, when we see the hot stuff.
Was it from Eastwood?
What was the Eastwood game? Yeah,
I don't know. It's usually a guy from Eastwood that says,
yeah,
it
calls
I'm
us
Genoa Homer.
Yeah, Genoa Broadcasting Network here. And I really do want to give thanks out to all the great Genoa people that have helped us out for, you know, we've been doing this 17 years
now,
brother.
Yeah, man, I mean, Genoa's like home. These guys, man, they treat us well, man. Yeah. You treat us well, man, we'll treat you well. It's real easy. Otsego, hint.
They love us. Otsego. But you know what? Otsego has their own live streaming company, so we don't get to go over there and do any games. And a lot of the kids run the show over there and do a wonderful job.
Well, inside handoff, Andrew Hill, he'll pick up positive yards and move the pile, moving the Comets inside the red zone. So the Comets set up shop now inside the red zone.
Once again, now you're seeing a little bit more of the Genoa smash mouth football that we've been used to over the years, you know, where they're running it. I'm a little iffy with a quarterback running so much because I don't want anyone to get hurt. But he's gaining so much yardage that, you know, you got to kind of stick with it.
Mike, when your quarterback's 6'4", 200 pounds, man, you know, you kind of roll with that handoff. Messenger breaks it to the outside. He's being strung out, and he's being chased out.
Uh-oh, that'll be
by
a flag.
Number 15, Farley.
That'll be a flag.
And
do you see one?
Tyler Michael and the Genoa thinking that it's going to be a flag. I don't think it was too excessive on there.
He got around.
As he just kind of pushed him out and kind of pushed him in, you know.
Right into our cameraman.
Yeah. Duck.
Ah, Rick's a big boy. He can handle it.
He can handle it. He can handle it.
Knock them on their butts.
It's going to bring up third down, Mike. It's be third and about three. So big third down right here for Otsego. Bronkhorst under center. He'll turn. He'll hand. Left side. He'll try.
Nope.
Entry. He may be short. Otsego thinks he's short. Genoa thinks they have it. It's going to be just short.
I don't think so.
It's going to be just short of the line of gain.
They call it?
It's fourth and one. Fourth and less than a yard. Bronkhorst again. Big fourth down right here. Can the Knights come up with a big turn away and repel the line? I'm telling you right now, they're going to run it left side. And they got him to jump.
Yeah, they jumped.
Off the hard count.
Wow. Early in the hard count, too.
Aiden Brunkhorst goes hard count, gets several Knights to jump. And there's another cheap first down. And this, boy,
two in this drive.
Looks, when they look back at this, just the miscues that they've had. On this fourth down, you give away a four. You actually had forced a punt, a three and out.
Yep.
And you turn it over on too many men on the field. Bucks, he'll turn hand inside handoff, and I tell you what, that hole closed in a hurry.
Yeah, watch that.
Number 70, Tyler O'Brien was first man there. First, second, and goal now from the 5-yard line. Genoa threatening. Broncos under center. He'll turn. Inside handoff. Antry, he'll try that left side, and he'll be not turned away. Boy, I tell you, first one there this time was Tyler Michael. Michael did a good job at getting small, Mike, and getting in through the gap, and then really, really squaring his pads and filling the gap.
Once again, this is where Genoa plays good smash-mouth football. But Otsego's holding them right now.
Here's a third down. It'd be interesting to see if Genoa decides to spread them out and throw it, or if they're going to go ahead and run it again. There's confusion in the Genoa right now. And there you go. They're going to take time out. 8:54 to go here in the fourth quarter. Genoa driving, and they're leading it 14-12. Come back and watch the conclusion of this one.
Hey everybody, it's Steve Taylor from the Taylor Automotive family. It is September, and that means it is Free Car Friday all month long. We're giving away another vehicle at the end of this month, and you could be the lucky winner this month. You know, we've already given away 6 fantastic vehicles this year. This month, we're going to change things up a little bit. We're having a scavenger hunt. You can get a golden ticket anywhere in Northwest Ohio. We'll be out and about in the communities, Toledo, Perrysburg, Findlay, Lima. We will have some of our people out in the communities. We'll let you know on Facebook where we'll be. We'll give you clues, and all you have to do is come up and get one of those golden tickets, and that means you got a chance to win this fantastic vehicle in September. It is simple, but don't forget, you got to go to our Facebook page. You got to like, comment, and share on that pinned post. It is that easy. Have some fun in September. Be on the lookout for the golden ticket, and maybe you can win that new car. We'll see you. Have a good one.
You just heard from Steve Taylor. I am Steve Taylor. He is Mike James.
We knew there'd come a day, right?
Actually, he and I have talked several times, and he said two Steve Taylors is better than one. Yeah. And I have to agree with the man.
Yeah. I'm not going to say nothing. I just keep my mouth shut because I'm really good at opening my mouth and inserting foot. So God love you both. Thank you. You're both part of the Toledo Sports Network or the Genoa Sports Network, whatever we're
going
to call it.
Yeah.
I like that.
The one and only Genoa Sports announcer. Bronkhorst, he'll turn inside handoff.
Oh, he's
breaking a tackle.
Archery,
but he was upended. That's just a nice defensive play by Otsego. They really wasn't having it. Man, look at the second level. 24, yep. Once again, Tyler Michael gets there and cuts down the ball carrier. Both legs. You can't run when you don't have your legs, Mike.
Yeah, that's for sure. And when you get upended like that, Otsego did exactly what they needed to do. They had to upend him because they knew they were going to run it.
Biggest play of the game right here, Mike. Fourth down, and they're going to spread him out. They're going to get a timeout because there was mass confusion on the Otsego defense. They're going to take timeout. We'll take timeout with them. It's Otsego, Genoa. Genoa leads it 14-12.
At Genoa Custom Interiors, we provide quality service at competitive prices. We offer a variety of flooring and interior design options customized to fit your needs. From carpets to hardwood, no matter what type of flooring you desire, we have what you want. Our designers will show you how to set up furniture, flooring, window treatments. Contact us today for a free estimate for any of our interior design, installation, and services. Genoa Custom Interiors.
Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street right next to Nick and Jimmy. With top-of-the-line golf simulators, duckpin bowling, and the best food for your night out. We've got you covered. It's Pro Golf Fairways with all the greatest golf courses in the area. Why not come out and hit a few with us at Pro Golf Fairways at Cameo Pizza and Resets in Rossford and Monroe Street next to Nick and Jimmy.
Mike Jamison and Jamison.
Well, here we're back. Fourth down, big fourth down. Jones, he'll spread them out. They'll send Messenger in motion. They know it's manned. They'll look,
wide
throw
open.
It to Messenger.
That's a touchdown. He was wide open.
for the Genoa Bank. Touchdown.
Well,
you didn't have to say nothing.
Well, Mike, what happens is the man in motion tells the quarterback the defense that he's facing. He knew when the linebacker went with Messenger that he had the coverage that he wanted. He just waited for him to clear. He clears as the extra point clears. He waited for him to clear. He hit him, and that's a Genoa Bank touchdown to Messenger. 21-12 is your score.
Different problems require different solutions. Seagate Roofing and Foundation Services has been solving water problems for over 30 years. We have the expertise to provide you with the best solution. Seagate replaces foundations, straightens walls, lifts sinking foundations, and waterproofs basements. Get your free estimate before you make a decision because you deserve to have all the facts. We are the local experts.
244 LEAK Seagate.
To Friday night at Jim Firestone Field at Genoa Bank Stadium.
You're all right up there? What the hell's going on?
Oh, my gosh, man. Some of the things that are said in the press box are just, they are meant to stay in the press box.
Is that why I'm so lucky that I shut the mics off when we go into a commercial break?
Absolutely.
Hey, I want to get some thanks out to Seagate Roofing. You know, Seagate Roofing put me on payroll this week, buddy. I'm going to be handling all of their social media and marketing. I'm really excited about that. And they work with us on our football games, our Let's Fix Her Up show, our boat show. Tom Elders and Steve Naylor have been doing everything with us. And thank you so much. 244 LEAK Seagate. There.
Barnett will pick up the loose ball, and he'll take it across field and be upended at the 23-yard line, and that's where Otsego will do business. First and 10. They're going to have to pick up the pace now. They're down two scores. It's 8:02 to go in this one.
You know, you're the musician in this group here, so did I sing okay?
A jingle is a jingle.
A jingle is a jingle. Okay. All right. And just leaving it there. I'm just glad we got a great game tonight. These guys are playing their butts off.
Farley, he'll fake the inside handoff.
Guess
turn,
what?
Throw, catches his man on the slant. He breaks a tackle. He's out over the 40 to the 30. He's got 20 to the 10, the 5. Touchdown. That'll be Jack Simpson. And what an answer.
Wow. Wow, we had it on our one field cam here. I don't know if we had it or not. I think we got early part of it. And then what a great, just split them. What a great run. Wow.
I'll tell you, good.
I like it.
A good play fake right there. Really did a good job at selling it all the way. It was Farley. And then he threw a laser.
Well, we've talked about it all night, Steve. That middle in the timing patterns is what's open on both sides now. And Genoa just didn't cover on that. I mean, they had two guys. It was missed tackles.
Extra point is up, and it is good. So 7:51, and Otsego answers. We've got 21-19. We're going to step aside, and we're going to come back. This is starting to heat up. Make sure you stay with us.
Skyworks is a family-owned and operated business specializing in new and used aerial work platforms, sales, rentals, and service. In addition to aerial lifts, we offer material handling equipment, construction equipment, sales featuring new and used telehandlers, excavators, skid steers, scissor lifts, boom lifts, and forklifts, and much more. Contact Skyworks today, 419-662-8630. Proud sponsor of high school sports in the area.
Twice now, Otsego has needed answers, and twice now they've been up to the task. Mike Jamison alongside Steve Taylor bringing you all the action. This one here is turning into a fantastic one. Genoa's up 21-19, and Mike, the shot in the arm that Otsego needed, they got. But now
It's back to the defense. They're going to have to get the ball back for their offense.
Well, and that's the one thing Genoa can do. They can hold on to the ball. They have such a balanced attack from the running game all the way out to you got the guy that can pop a 50-yard pass like it's nothing. So that's going to be, you know, Otsego's going to have to make those stops. They're going to have to make those short stops. That's what's hurt them was the short stops. And they can't get in any more penalties.
Offside kick attempted. And Genoa is going to cover. This time falling on the ball was Luke Clement.
Yeah, we didn't see that.
Clement comes up with a big play, but that puts Genoa in business right around midfield, Mike. They've got excellent field position.
And they have what they want to do is take time off the clock. They want to take time off the clock. They want those 2 and 3 yard gains and then just blow out for one of these outline passes. I think that's what they're going to be setting themselves up for.
And they're really trying to catch the defense slapping. They're going to send Messenger in motion. Fake handoff. He's going to keep it himself. Weaving through the defense. It's Broncos breaking the tackle at midfield.
There's a flag.
And going to be tackled. Looks like we're going to get a late flag. That's going to be a face mask.
Yes,
they're going to add 15 more on to that.
What did we just talk about, Steve? What did we just talk about?
Yeah, you really got to be really stellar and not give up any penalties. And right here, once again, you see it.
Yep.
That's going to be the 15-yard variety. Hmm. As they discuss it to see if it'll be that's a personal foul 15-yarder.
Did you say personal foul face mask?
Yeah. That's going to be a 15-yard variety. So, Genoa's going to pick up 15 more to go on top of that. And that's going to put the ball down at the 32-yard line.
It's like lighting a firecracker on both ends. Yeah, that's what's been happening to Otsego here. And, you know, they're playing great football. And then, you know, these just little things. And I know with a face mask 9 times out of 10, It's just one of them things, your hands up there, you know, but that was a pretty deliberate one right there. I'm not saying he did it deliberately, but, you know, he got him up high. So what do you do?
Extra man down in the box. Messenger, but shifty feet, breaks back to the other side. That play was designed to go left. The sweet feet of Messenger broke it back to the right.
Yep.
You see him right there. He understands it. Stuck his foot in the ground, Mike, broke it back to the right. And runs the daylight. And he's going to move the chains.
I don't even have to change the first down thing.
You sure don't, because it's going to be first and 10 in the red zone for the Genoa Comets.
Not too cold tonight. You know, I'm not complaining too much here.
Motion man.
Oh,
inside
nice.
Handoff. Yeah. That was Antry, and Antry, they weren't having any of it, and he's upended right away.
Heck no. Even faked out our cameraman there.
Well, they did a good job of pulling Schenever that time, the big 6'2", 288-pound guard. Got him moving, but good job by the interior of Otsego holding up. Boy, 6:12 to go. And Genoa milking the clock on the drive in the red zone. Broncos under center. He'll keep. Damn. He'll run left. Gets to the edge. And he'll break a tackle and take it into the end zone.
Wow.
Blocked well on the left side. You know, when you look at it, boy, you see everybody does his job. They just outflanked. They outflanked the.
There's the block that made it happen right there, too.
Well, anytime you get long runs, Mike, you're going to always see wide receivers blocking downfield. And Genoa lines up for the extra point. 5:58 to go here in this one. The extra point is up, and it is good. So Genoa answer the Otsego answer. 5:58 to go. Genoa leads it 28-19.
I'm just going to stay here. I'll
Bronc horse.
Whoa. I'm probably going to cut it out. Come back like you would normally cut it out because I'm probably going to need time, and this is one of those places I can take it out.
Okay.
So right when they get ready to roll. And, wow, what a game. Absolutely. I'm so glad. Thank you, Steve. So glad. What is the Eastwood-Rossford score?
It was a lot to a little.
Okay. You said something like 47
it
to 14.
It was 42-14 last I heard.
Oof. Okay, you can go.
Welcome back to Genoa, where the Comets have just added on to their lead. They lead it 28-19 alongside Mike Jameson. I'm Steve Taylor. Mike Jameson, Bronchorse has 11 carries, 116 yards to go with that touchdown that he just added on.
Well, I mean, there has to be a way to stop him. But the great thing about that kid is if you go and stop him, he's just going to step back and throw it 30 yards.
And that's what they're doing, Mike. They're inviting him up, man. They're bringing the extra safety up to try to control the run. And now they're spreading him out to try to get him out. And there we go, Barnett. He'll be upended at the 27-yard line. But that's the problem that you deal with Genoa these days now, because they're not just going to run it. They have the ability to be able to spread you out across the field and take advantages of mismatches. Speaking of mismatches, Otsego did just that. They went to their big play guy the last series, Jack Simpson, and he came up golden. Let's see if they go back to him again, Mike. Three by one set. Farley, he'll step back, he'll look to throw, throws the deep out, and he'll complete it to Owen Atkinson.
Great. Oh, I didn't get it, I guess. Sorry about that. Boy, I'm just, you know me. I know you get mad when I don't have replay on every play.
That don't have to be on everyone.
All right.
It's going to be a completion of about 8 yards, second and two. Farley has spread him out. He'll roll to his right, throw his right, and he'll complete right. This will be Kenton Wallace. He'll have enough for the first down, so they'll move the sticks.
That was the play that got him the touchdown in the last series. And really smart play. Bring it up to the other side, and they were able to do it. They've got open field this way now.
He'll throw left, complete left, smoke screen. Jake Limes.
Yeah. Get him what, a couple?
That'll get him about two. It'll be second and eight. 4:53 and counting. Farley, he'll empty. He'll go twins to each side. Genoa showing blitz, and they bring it. Stepping into a throw, going to that seam route.
Oh.
And we're going to get a late flag on the outside. Looks like the legs of number 34, Dom Lindenberger, got tied up on the seam as he was trying to link up with his big play guy again, Jack Simpson.
That'll get him in great field position.
That's going to get interference. So that'll give you 15 yards, and that'll put him inside of Genoa Comet territory.
First down.
It'll be first and 10 from the Genoa 43-yard line.
Steve, I'm going to let you, after this play, I want you to make our unsung hero of the game. That doesn't mean that was the best player. That doesn't mean anything. The Taylor Automotive unsung hero.
Flushed out of the pocket is Farley. He breaks a tackle, spins, looking for a man, looks downfield, throws.
Really got
him. A man wide open. Caught Kenton Wallace, and that's going to put him in great field position. First and 10 from the 12-yard line. What a play by Farley.
Wow. He caught it. Nice job.
Farley gets him up to the line of scrimmage. Genoa showing blitz. Farley checking off. He's got trips to his left. He'll look left, throw left, complete. Smoke screen.
Look at this. Nice job.
And that's Jake Limes. Take barreling in, and he's down close to another first down.
Second and one, maybe?
Second and two.
Hey, make it three. It'll be a long three.
Quit blowing that horn up there.
Here, 350 to go. Farley, he'll take inside handoff. Barnett pushing toward the goal line, but he's turned away. Beerbaum, he's the first one there. Zach Beerbaum turns him away, the inside linebacker.
And as you can see in the middle of that screen, that clock keeps running.
Tick, 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 tick. 3:30 to go. Play clock is at 27, as you can see.
Third and one.
Center of your screen. Third and two. Farley. Looking over the defense, he'll turn handoff, inside handoff.
No, maybe
it'll be
not.
Still it'll be close to a first down. Otsego think they have it. Stop me by. It's gonna be real close.
Calling you out. Fourth and one.
Fourth and one. It'll bring up fourth down. And here it is. Big play. Fourth and one. They'll move the pocket. Farley, he'll take it himself. Looks for the end zone, and he waltzes in.
He got it. There's offense on both sides of this ball tonight, Steve.
Man, both of these teams coming up with the answers. Another hot single answer. I like the moxie of this kid, Devin Farley.
At this point, they got to go for two.
Well, not necessarily.
Well, still, no, you're right.
It's a three-point game. Right. I would actually kick the extra point because all you need is three to win if that's the case. Extra point is down. It's up, and it sneaks over.
Got it.
Wow. So 2:40 to go in this one. It is a barn burner. Genoa leads Otsego 28-26. Come back and watch the finish of High School Game of the Week.
Genoa Bank is celebrating 120 years. Hi, I'm Marty Sutter, President and CEO of Genoa Bank. Since 1902, Genoa Bank has been caring for the financial needs of our neighbors. Our roots remain as we continue to serve our customers, our communities, and our families. Genoa Bank celebrates 120 years by reflecting on our past and, more importantly, focusing on our future. We will continue to make a positive difference in the lives of those who work, bank, and invest at Genoa Bank.
Welcome back to Friday Night Lights right here at Jim Firestone Field. Mike, here's the situation. We've got 2:40 to go in this one. Otsego just cut the Genoa lead to two. They only have one timeout left. Do you anticipate an onside kick here?
Yes. Yes, definitely. Well, you know, yeah, definitely. They got to get the ball back. They definitely got to get the ball back. So I'm going to say there will be definitely an onside kick. Looks like they're kind of setting up for it, too.
Well, with one timeout left, Mike, they really have to. But the onside kick is what gave Genoa great field position the last possession, and
yep,
they were able to take a short field and punch it in for a touchdown. And it is an onside kick. It'll jump up, and it'll be recovered by Denver Stewart.
Well, you always wonder on them, and if you want to bounce, that's the bounce you want if the ball's coming to you.
but you see what Denver Stewart does. He goes and gets the ball and doesn't wait for the ball. How many times do you see players wait for the ball to come to them?
Yeah, that ball went in the air. It just said, yeah, that's my baby.
Go get the ball.
Exactly.
So 2:38 to go. A first down will pretty much do it, Mike.
Nothing special here. I see it up the middle.
Left side. On the left side. It's been effective all night. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. And that's exactly what they do. They go left side. Antry was the ball carrier. Number six over there to knock him down was Jack Simpson. Second and eight. Bronkhorst under center. He'll turn, he'll hand, and it'll be Antry, and he'll be pushed out of bounds, and that will help the cause of Otsego, Mike.
It will help the cause?
Yeah, because the clock stops.
Yep, exactly.
So that's going to be a third down, third and five.
Manageable, though.
It's third and five. I mean, here's the biggest play of the game for the defense of Otsego. We've said that a lot already today, Mike. This is the biggest play because they can conceivably get off the field here and get the ball back. Motion. Inside handoff. Messenger, he'll get the first down. That's and move game. The chains. Boy, you see, he would not be denied.
And that was just pure nice misdirection right there,
exactly.
Too.
Exactly.
Wow.
Everybody blocked down, Mike, and they ran the ball back to the left side. Nicely done to the right side, excuse me.
Yeah, basically all Genoa has to do is hold on to the ball now. Let that clock go down. It's not like the NFL and that two-minute warning.
But they can pretty much take knees at this point.
Yeah, he's timing it all down.
Broncos, 4 seconds on the play clock, and he snaps it just before zero, inside handoff. It'll be Antry, and Antry will be upended by Devin Farley. Farley, boy, getting in on it from the defensive side.
Now, next week, we'll have the Genoa-Elmwood game at this point. We kind of got to run our schedules around BCSN, and there's, you know, that's why everybody's been asking. We haven't done a lot of Rossford games. We usually do a lot of Rossford games, too, along with Genoa.
Man, y'all be having us outside, man. I ain't sitting out in the cold.
Yeah, I figured that. I'll bring you a heater. But, no, I think we're going to go down and do the Genoa-Elmwood game. I think that'll be the best game of the week here, and we'll see. We'll see. So go to the website, Toledo Sports Network. You're already there. And we'll have that up for you tomorrow.
Broncos takes it on the keeper.
Timing clock here. So
37 seconds to go in this one.
How much time's on the play clock?
And it is 12 seconds to go. They're going to take a knee here. And this, I don't think Genoa will have to snap it again. They won't. That's going to do it. So Genoa, they're going to move to 5-3. Via a 28-26 victory over Otsego, a game Otsego team who really came in and really swung toe-to-toe.
You know, I got to tell you, Steve, we got to wrap this up quick here, but great game on both sides. You could just see, you know, both teams were able to play some really, really good offense. But I'll tell you what, this game went to the defense. I need your unsung hero of the game.
Taylor Automotive unsung hero is Owen Atkinson, the defensive back from Otsego, taking a pick six all the way to the house. So Owen Atkinson is our Taylor Automotive unsung player of the week.
Thank you, Stephen, for putting this game together for us, and we'll see you next week. We want to wish Mick Gonzalez, get better, buddy. We miss you. Rick, Carlos, and Kurt just did a phenomenal job on camera tonight. Absolutely went perfect. We got to wrap it up real quickly here. Steve, take it.
Hey, man, thanks for joining us once again. Genoa, victorious. They win it 28-26. For Mike Jamison and the crew, I'm Steve Taylor. You've been watching High School.